Hello there. Welcome to Heart Explained Therapy. Now, the title says Heart Explained, and I felt that when I discovered that name, it made a lot of sense. A lot of people use their intellect and rationale, their mind. For me, there's an intuitive sort of place in all roles of society that's actually dictated more from the heart than the mind, even though the mind carries out the actions of the heart, if you like. Now, this subject today is going to be, what is love? And how do men and women attain it? And what do they really want? Because I think that we're coming up to a point for the first time where we can question this and we can really analyse it. I mean, not many people have done that many studies of love predating 1900s. Psychology has only just come out in the last 100 years, so it means that we're only really gathering what we do as a collective society. And a recent survey that's been going on for 75 years, the longest survey ever, which is technically not a survey based on happiness in general, but they wanted to see basically people's lives, how they live and how they became, or how certain people in this experiment became happy. And their conclusion overall was that people in a loving relationship, or with more loving relationships with family members and big sort of groups, were the happiest. Now, I think that this is talking about an unconscious desire that we have to find happiness within somebody else that makes us happy. And these people predated the 1920s when this first started, and it's still going on today. So you're talking at people that have come to the end of their life to produce, and then they've carried this on with sons and their sons, and the, you know, they're carrying on this sort of collective information. But I think they're talking about an unconscious desire, that a belief that we have that if we get on with big members of families and friends, and we have these big circles around us for support, life feels better. And that's clearly understandable why that would be true. It's what we all, in a way, unconditionally drive towards. I don't believe that it's consciously going to be a factor in the future. I think we're going to get more intelligent to understand that that's a spectrum of love. That's not really true love, and there's a deeper type of love. And that's understanding that you can be the only person left on planet Earth and not technically be any more alone than you was with a massive group of people around you. And that's a big point that people don't understand. And I just want to repeat that just so you really get it. What I'm saying is that I think the future of consciousness possibly could understand that you being alone on planet Earth can feel exactly the same as you with other people and a big support system around you. The loneliness is only an emotion dictated by you and the way that you interpret the current state of affairs. And that's why I think this survey is right with the evidence they've found. But they found the evidence in an unconscious human being. And all statistics are based on unconscious human beings telling people this is what we believe is to be true. And they don't know themselves. They don't know the truth about their experience. What they do best is guess. So what does this tell us about love? Well, for me, real love is when you can understand that you don't need anybody else to fulfill you or to make you feel good. You ever had that somebody say a critique, a negative thing about you, and you feel terrible? That shouldn't be a factor. You shouldn't have that low self-esteem to feel bad when your partner says something negative about you. And it doesn't mean that you have to unconsciously react and be angry. It means that you know that there's probably something very negative going on in that person outside of you for them to be negative towards you. Or they can just have an opinion that you might believe isn't even right. And it doesn't have to affect you. And the affecting bit is crucial. And I'm going to come to this now in the relationship bit. If we introspect ourselves and grow, we realise that we don't really need anybody to love us, to feel love. And we can love even better with this love that doesn't come from an external source. Which means that your relationships could get a lot better if you set up the boundaries of what you want back from other people. Whereas before, you want invisible transactions that can't be met because you never communicate what you want. And I think men and women are drifting apart now, because if a man does anything sort of what would be seen as a primal instinct from the past, today's modern society calls it actually sexist or a belittling of the feminine woman and a horrible showing of masculinity. I know people that don't like flowers, teddies, for gifts. I know people who don't like the doors being held open because that's seen as you don't need to do that now. I'm my own person, I'll get my own door. In fact, I'll open your door to make you feel small. And it's just, we're getting away from instincts that are quite naturally okay. Another one is, I'm just going to say this now and then explain why it's not what you think it is. Men can't do what women can do. And feminists all around the world are saying that's brilliant. But women can't do some things that men can do. Now this is crucial. And I think this is where we get it wrong. I think in a relationship now, it's more, I can do everything all on my own. And the other person is like, just wanting to understand. And I think the communication has gone. And it's like now that we're living in a world where we have to be telepathic to understand everybody else's needs. Everybody's oversensitive. If you say anything that has been part of your life for a long time, it could actually be outdated if you haven't watched the news for 3 weeks. So we're living in a very difficult time, and males and females are going in the opposite direction. And feminism thinks this is great because women won't be suppressed, but you're getting rid of masculine men who in the end won't want to do anything, because they will just constantly be confused about what to do, when really men are actually quite stupid and they need to be told what to do. This is just their natural instinct because they haven't got the emotional intelligence that females have. But then females can't necessarily do a dynamic thing that a man can do. And this is okay to say, I need you for this. It doesn't have to be a war about sexes. And I think we're getting to a very dangerous part of the 21st century now. The next way that we go is going to decide on what sort of man and female and what sort of relationship exists in the future. And I see people now not talking. I see short-term relationships, often very short-term and very quickly to get into a short-term relationship. And I also see sexuality exploding in all sorts of directions, which everyone believes is positive. But I don't think it is as positive. I think it's a byproduct of an unconscious behaviour that we've accidentally adopted because of our oversensitivity. And in a way, you could say it's evolution. You could say it's the process taking part. So it's not necessarily negative, but it's very different. It's different how you now would rather short-term serotonin hits through addictive behaviours and addictive substances and addictive patterns of behaviours like lost in television, lost in shopping, lost in sort of any distraction really, other than relationship, talking, experiencing the moment. And I think there's a reason for that. And it's just because you can't handle it. You haven't got that love within. And it goes back to that introspection. How much do you want to experience this life? Or how much do you want a mini hit of serotonin, which is short term? Just like the relationships, just like the fads that you have, just like the news. It's all, wow, this is the worst thing in the world and we should all stand up as a community and defend it. And then 1 week later, it has been totally forgotten and everyone's just back to normal. Not sure if this explains anything really. It's very complicated, but it's going in a strange direction. And the old values are gone. The marriage, the real traditional values that actually made love love. It made it an experience. It made it important. It sort of sowed the seeds of loyalty and passion and all these things that you believe that you don't want anymore. But I think there's a deep yearning for that always in any